Pleasant good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Turfway Park. Tonight is closing night of our 20-night holiday meet. We have a couple of mandatory payouts. Our 20-cent single six jackpot, better than $36,000. In fact, we have more than a couple mandatory payouts throughout the card. Super High 5 carryover, and the nightcap $13,890.52. So a couple of carryovers with the 20-cent single six jackpot, the Super High 5, mandatory payouts for closing night of our holiday meet. Let's open up our programs and get right into the changes in the opener, scratching 5 and 9, Casino Annie and Janie Lee, 5 and 9, both scratched from our Saturday night opener. As always, the opener will begin the early double, the early pick 3, and the early pick 5. And there they go. Redneck Agenda towards the tail of the field. Agoria showing speed from the inside. Cabin Abbey, fleet of foot from the far outside. I Got Rhythm is third. I'm going to Elegant Moves with Written Consent from the far outside. Clovertown is second last, covering Redneck Agenda. Agoria is a little quicker than Cabin Abbey. They are 1-2 through the early stages. In the third spot, Elegant Moves with the favorite, Written Consent. I Got Rhythm's back to the fifth spot. Redneck Agenda's being pulled up. I Got Rhythm. I Got Rhythm now at the back as Clovertown assumes the spot just in front of her. So it's Agoria and Cabin Abbey, and chasing them, Elegant Moves. And from the outside, Written Consent. Clovertown's picking up her stride from the fifth spot, but she still has work to do. She's a good 6 or 7 lengths off the lead. Agoria and Cabin Abbey been this way from the beginning. Written Consent's closing in. Clovertown is tipped to the far outside, and she continues with her run. It still is Agoria. She has put away Cabin Abbey, and she's clear past the 16th. Written Consent's into the second spot. Clovertown is third. Agoria still with the lead in deep stretch, and Agoria's going to win the Saturday night opener. From Written Consent, Clovertown, Cabin Abbey checked in for. Number one, Agoria all the way. Pressed along by a Cabin Abbey, put that rival away. No late threats, one Agoria all the way. Under Fernando de la Cruz, 113 and 57 100ths. Seven, Written Consent, second. Third place, 3, Clovertown. Fourth place, 8, Cabin Abbey. 1-7-3-8 in the Saturday night opener. Make sure to hold all tickets. Agoria makes her way into the winner's circle. She is the unofficial winner of our Saturday night opener. Here is Agoria, a 3-year-old, the Chestnut Filly by Mucho Macho Man, out of the Ghost Zapper mare, Cape Hayes, owned by Nana's Nest and Robert Klein. Robert is the winning trainer, winning jockey, Fernando de la Cruz. And it was bred in Kentucky by John R. Penn and John C. Penn. Exacta, $31.90, Trifecta, $27.64, 10 cents Super, $23.83. Dollars Superfecta, $238.35. Tonight's second race will begin the early pick 4. German Terraza, new jockey, number 1, Rocket Docket, the weight's good. Scratched the also eligible 13, I Once Stood Alone. 6 Treasury, 1 pound over, 9 all jokes aside, 2 pounds over the weight. 23 minutes until the early pick 4, 6:25 is the post time. And there they go. Money, Money, Slew, all jokes aside, Cielo Azul, these 3 are quickly into stride. Hinks Paladin is also forwardly positioned with Champion by Design. Raph is outside of Treasury. Buzzer goes with them. And then we have Agador Spartacus. Indefatigable is advancing from the extreme outside. Rocket Docket is second last. And Violin Maker is the last of all. All jokes aside, fleet of foot, he's the quickest of all, heading into the far turn run. From Cielo Azul, a Money Money Slew and Champion by Design. Indefatigable is currently midfield. He's 5 lengths from the front, just in front of him, both Treasury and Hank's Paladin. Treasury is committed to at least a 3 or 4 wide run. He's under a vigorous drive. Indefatigable's now picking up his best stride. Raff's starting to take off. They all need to take off and step up to the leader, who is all jokes aside. All jokes aside, at the eighth pole, has the lead in the margins nearly 4 lengths. Champion by Design is second. Treasury from the outside. Indefatigable finds a slip along the rail. Good stride for him, but he's no threat to All Jokes Aside. All Jokes Aside wins pretty comfortably from Indefatigable, Champion by Design, and Buzzer completed the superfecta. Back-to-back 6 furlong affairs. One with forwardly positioned horses, Agore in the opener. All Jokes Aside here in the second half of the early double under Tyler Connor. 7-1 upsetter, 111 and 60 100ths was the final running time. 9 All Jokes Aside, the unofficial winner. 12 Indefatigable ran a very good race in defeat, clearly second. Third place to the 2, Champion by Design, and looked like the 4, Buzzer for the Super, yep. Those numbers are on the board, 9, 12, 2, 4, unofficially in tonight's second. And the winner's circle is number 9, All Jokes Aside. It's his third career victory, a 3-year-old chestnut, a gelding by a Danzig Candy. Out of the Spitestown mare, hottest thing in town. Owned by Foxbrook Farm LLC. Winning trainer is Anna Mamma Mia. And the winning jockey is Tyler Gunner. All Jokes Aside was bred in California by Rising Star Farm. That exact to $145.48. The trifecta, $203.69. A 1-9 early double, $47.44. 10 cent super, $391.86. Dollar superfecta, $3,918.66. Third race offering a double and a mid-pick 3. It's clear of change. Tonight's third race is in 22 minutes at 6:55. Fans, don't miss out on this cash frenzy of free play this evening, fans. Sign up and be part of our Players Club. All the way up until 11 p.m. every 7 minutes, we are drawing a winner to win up to $700 in free play. And there they go. Miss Love Shack begins quickly. From the inside is Ellie Deli. She's also quickly into stride along with Tizza Country Girl from the inside. Ellie Deli and Tizza Country Girl. Miss Love Shack has the third spot. And right there with her is Dash of Simplicity. Start singing from the outside. Hope Over Fear on the rail. She has to put on the brakes momentarily. From her outside is Hashtag Winner. And then Dance the Day Away. Mizzen Ash and On a Tour are the last 2. So it is Ellie Deli by almost 3 parts of a length. Tis a Country Girl has the rail. Miss Love Shack's forwardly positioned from third. And here starts singing with the Black Silk. She's only 2.5 lengths off the lead. A length back to the inside runner. That is Dash of Simplicity. Dance the Day Away from the far outside, at least 3 deep. 3 lengths from the front. And they'll go to Mizzen Ash, who races with Hope Over Fear. Hope Over Fear races with Hashtag Winner. And at the tail of the field remains On a Tour. So it is Ellie Deli with the lead. Start Singing is making her move. Start Spreading the News. Here comes Start Singing to the outside. And she's ready to gain the upper hand at the quarter pole, and she's the one to beat. Start Singing, finds the front coming at her. Here comes some players. Mizzen Ash is closing to the outside. Start Singing getting first run on Mizzen Ash. Start Singing has the lead near the eighth pole. Mizzen Ash has a look to her outside. Start Singing and Mizzen Ash. Ellie Deli's back to third. Start Singing. Did she move too soon? Here's Mizzen Ash to her outside. Start Singing and Mizzen Ash. Start Singing. Mizzen Ash to the outside. Who's it going to be? Head-bobbing finish between Mizzen Ash and Start Singing. Dash of Simplicity was third, and fourth place to Tis a Country Girl. Oh, some rowdy fans on the apron. Obviously, they think their horse got the photo. Was it Mizzen Ash or Start Singing? 140 and 19 100ths the final time. Make sure to hold all tickets. Mizzen Ash is in the winner's circle, a 5-year-old Grey Roan mare by Mizzen Mast. Out of the Katianis mare, She's a smitten kitten by Southwest Racing Stables Incorporated. Genaro Garcia is the winning trainer. The winning jockey is Yarmarie Correa. Winner was bred in Indiana by Captain Jack Racing Stable. 9842. Top four finishers, Exacta $70.46. Trifecta $356.50. The 10-cent Superfecta $308.55. Dollar Superfecta $3,085.51. 199 early pick three, $247.39. 99 daily double, $64.09. Fourth race begins, a 20-cent single six jackpot. We got a mandatory payout this evening, fans. We got a nice carryover, $36,490.75. 20 cents, maybe, who knows? Maybe you walk away with 100 G's, maybe even more, you never know. Changes in the sequence. Fourth race scratch both of the also eligibles, 13 and 14. Queen Lexi, Frosty Tail. Five Taprit Warrior, make the jockey German Tarraza, corrected weight 112 pounds. German's a 7-pound bug, the weight's 112. Four and seven both carry a 1 pound over the weight. And there they go. A slow start, she's a saint. What you wished is gunned from the inside. Taprit Warrior wants to go with Old Fashioned Girl. Ladle's in a prominent position from the outside. What you wished and Old Fashioned Girl, the two quickest. And Ladle's right there forcing the issue. And here comes Vino from Ernie striding into the fourth spot. Taprit Warrior from her outside, then Serene Waters. Far outside is Dash of Lemon. Then we've got a Sprat. Here's the favorite, Everland. She is fourth last. My Dixieland Delight is third last. Then we've got a She's a Saint. And Calle Reina is the last of all. And Ladle has been intent on making the lead. It looks like they're going pretty good up front, 23 and two fifths. It's a very ambitious tempo. Ladle has the lead from What You Wished. Old Fashioned Girl was amongst the action. She backs off from third. She's in a good spot. And Vino from Ernie's is traveling well enough along the inside. And here comes Everland. She's following in her footsteps up the inside. Ladle has the lead, disposing of What You Wished. Old Fashioned Girl and Vino from Ernie's are closing in. Everland had all sorts of trouble. What You Wish took a very awkward step, and it really compromised Everland midway through the turn. In the meantime, Old Fashioned Girl has momentum, and she's right alongside of Ladle. And here comes Serene Waters. Now, Everland has made a quick recovery. Look at Everland showing tremendous athleticism, and she's the one to key on. Can she make a way through? It's been such a troubled trip for her. Serene Waters has the lead. Old Fashioned Girl. Here is Everland up the inside, and Vino from Ernie's. Everland's taking off. How good is Everland this evening? She deserves this victory. Vino from Ernie's is fighting with her, but it's Everland. Everland, I like your style, girl. Everland wins the money from Vito from Ernie's. Third and fourth involves My Dixieland Delight and Serene Waters. That was pretty awesome, fans. I'm not a chalk-eating weasel by any means, but when you see 6-5 and you see her getting in trouble, you better take notice. She had no right to win, fans. The two, What You Wish, took a very awkward step midway through the turn. I thought for sure it compromised Everland's chances, showing tremendous athleticism. She deserved the I Like Your Style call, no question about it. Seven Everland at 6-5. The one Vino from Ernie's ran a very good race. The final running time, 140 and 55 100ths. Seven Everland first, second to the one Vino from Ernie's. Third place six, My Dixieland Delight. Fourth place four, Serene Waters. 7-1-6-4. Once again, 140 and 55 100ths that final time. There is Everland. How impressive was she this evening? A two-year-old Grey Roan Filly by Arrogate. Out of the Tappet Mare Ever Changing, owned by Augustine Stable, winning trainer Jonathan Thomas, winning a jockey, the Bug Boy, Axel Concepcion. It was bred in Kentucky by George Strawbridge Jr. Axel gets within two of Luan Machado. We got a jockey's race with five races to go. There's that Exacta, $14.34, the Trifecta, $39.72, a 9-7 daily double, $37.94. 10-cent Super, $52.04, Dollar Super, $520.40, 997 Pick 3, $183.19. Mandatory payouts for the closing night of the holiday meet. Our late pick five is up next. Scratch both of the also eligibles post time at about 24 minutes at 7:59. And there they go. Stumbling start, a dollar a day. Beautiful Bolt and Peeping fire out together. Sherbet Fountains right there behind them inside of River Oaks. From the inside races Milan Mischief. And it's Peeping who's eager to make this lead from Beautiful Bolt. From the inside, Milan Mischief and Sherbet Fountain going with her. Cromaldi's in the fifth position. River Oaks is sixth. And what a Jungle Cat, Queen Rainiera. Better Justice from the far outside. Ojema Bay, third last. Cushy, second last. A dollar a day, who stumbled at the start, is the last of 12, 24 seconds from Peeping on the lead. Beautiful Bolt's ready to attack her from the outside in second. Sherbet Fountain, forwardly positioned in the clear, three deep. Milan Mischief from the inside, then Cromaldi. Better Justice, River Oaks, also there. Queen Rainiera and Jungle Cat from the inside, a little less than four lengths off the lead. Three lengths to Ojema Bay with Cushy from her outside. And a dollar a day is still at the back. And here's Beautiful Bolt getting the lead. Sherbet Fountain's making her move to the outside. Beautiful Bolt and Sherbet Fountain. Cromaldi's third. Better Justice is fourth. Beautiful Bolt's the leader near the quarter pole. Sherbet Fountain needs to go after her. Beautiful Bolt slipping away. Cromaldi makes a move for second far outside. There is Better Justice. Queen Rainiera is looking for somewhere to go. She's outside of Sherbet Fountain. Here comes Queen Rainiera. Tight spot for her. She's trying to muscle her way into the contention. And here comes Jungle Cat diving to the inside with a furious finish. Jungle Cat's coming home quickly up the rail. Queen Rainiera to the stand side. Jungle Cat and Queen Rainiera. Jungle Cat! Jungle Cat from Queen Rainiera. Beautiful Bolt third. Sherbet Fountain fourth. Diving to the rail, Alex Ajard. Earlier this week, he utilized the overland route. How about this ride? Straight to the rail and got them all down. Jungle Cat. 139 and 63 100s. Big effort from the seven. Queen Rainiera at a big number, 12-1. Or Beautiful Bolt checking in third. Fourth place, five, Sherbet Fountain. Kindly retain all mutual tickets until results have been declared official. Jungle Cats making your way to the winner's circle. The Lone Mare, I've talked about this angle, fans. Five-year-old bay mare, the Lone Mare by Animal Kingdom out of the Hereditary Mare, Zutil. By Team Valor International. Rudy Brissett winning a trainer winning jockey, Alex Ajard. And it was bred in Kentucky by Team Valor International and Gary Barber. The Lone Mare Jungle Cat. Exacta $85.08. Trifecta $106.36. 7-8 chalky double for the most part, $8.98. Formful, I should say, not chalky, formful. Early pick four, $725.75, 10 cents super, $56.06, dollar superfecta, $560.64, 978 pick three, $66.31, early pick five, $2,946.07, 4 out of 5, $30.96. On to the sixth. A nice allowance sprint, field of nine after the scratch for the Queen's Jewels. 10 Graze the Boy has an additional workout, 18th of December, Churchill Downs, fast track, half mile, 50 seconds, breezing. Six starts are late pick four. And post time is in 23 minutes at 8:30. And there they go, slow start. Detroit City retained begins the best. Counter-Strike is up close to the action. Here is Antares, three of them scrimmage. Antares from between runners. Stone Vicious comes away in a good spot early on. He's in the fourth position. Then Bless the Kitten, Nifty, Detroit City after the awkward start. Gagetown towards the tail with Graze the Boy. And Tottery speeds clear from stablemate retained. Counter-Strike forwardly positioned along the rail. 2.5 off the lead heading into the turn. Stone Vicious has a little more than 3.5 lengths to make up. And from between runners, Nifty advances in the two path. Detroit City from the rail. Graze the Boy from the far outside. He covers. Bless the Kitten. Gagetown's at the back. Here comes Retain, turning up the pressure on his stablemate Antares. Counter strikes, just looking for somewhere to go. He's all dressed up in Sunday's best. Where's he going to go? Gets a split in the two path. Antares, counter strike still hemmed in. Retain, how about this tag team racing? Antares and Retain, counter strike. Here's Nifty in the clear from the outside. It is Antares, Antares! Antares wins the money. Might have got an assist from his stablemate Retain. Nifty was rolling on late. And Counter-Strike, boy, what trouble he had. 110 and 49 one-hundredths, the final running time. Troubled effort for the one Counter-Strike at a good number, 9-1. Had all sorts of trouble. Turning into the lane, Antares and Retain with some tag team racing. 110 and 49 one-hundredths. Here's the slow-mo, 5 Antares. Seized command immediately out of the gate. There's his stablemate Retained and Nifty outside of him, and there's the trouble with Counter Strike. Let the placing judges post the numbers. Make sure to hold all tickets. Antares along the inside, Counter Strike with the green cap and the black blinkers. You're going to see 5 Antares starts to drift out just a little bit, a continual drift. One Counter Strike's placing was affected. Stewards felt he did not get a chance at a proper placing, thus resulting in the disqualification of 5 Antares from first to fourth. You see right there, Gerardo Corrales goes to the left-hand whip, makes it awfully tight on the one Counter Strike. Stewards felt one Counter Strike was cost a chance at a proper placing, thus resulting in the disqualification of 5 Antares from first to fourth. Gonna look at it again. Corrales goes to the left hand, and Antares responds, and he drifts out, just impeding the one Counter Strike just a little bit, taking his path. Stewards felt a proper placing was affected, resulting in the disqualification. Since 8-8, double, $23.65. 10 cent super, $101.73. Dollar super, $1,017.39. 7-8-8, pick 3, $31.20. Next, our seventh and featured event. This is the $125,000 guaranteed holiday chair. It's the 24th running. It's a 6-furlong sprint. Some very nice sprinters, 3-year-olds and up. We have no changes in our holiday chair, our Saturday night featured event. It begins our late pick 3, and post time is in 21 minutes at 9:06. Tonight's seventh race is our Saturday night featured event, the 24th running of the holiday chair. $125,000 guaranteed, 6 furlongs, 3-year-olds and up. No changes. Let's meet the field. One is Heaven Street, owned by Paradise Farms Corporation, along with David Stadocker and Michael Dubb. The trainer is Michael Maker. The jockey is Axel Concepcion. Number 2 is Dabab, owned by Abdullah Saheed Al-Nabdua, conditioned by Edward Vaughn. Tyler Connor is in the irons. 3 is Maniwa, owned by Susan Moulton, conditioned by Will Walden. Abel Cedillo is the pilot. 4 is Hayden Noriega's Started From the Bottom, conditioned by John Ennis. The pilot, Adam Biskitsa. 5 is My Buddy Boy, owned by Bonnie Chance Farm. Paula Lobo conditions Charlie Oliveros, the jockey, a couple of pounds over. 6 is True Temper, owned by Jackpot Farm. His trader is Mark Cassie. His jockey is Luan Machado. 7 is Condemned, owned by Claiborne Farm, along with Adele Dilschneider, Thomas Drury, the conditioner, Joe Ramos, the pilot. 8 is Let My People Go, owned by BBN Racing LLC, Victoria Oliver, the trainer, the jockey, Martin Garcia. 9 is Fortin Hill, owned by OXO Equine LLC, Paulo Lobo, the trainer, Gerardo Corrales is aboard. Number 10 is Nighttime, owned by SB Stables LLC, Genstar Thoroughbreds, and David Burnson, and Omar Aldaba. Billy Morey conditions Fernando de la Cruz, looking for 3 on the Saturday card, and the 11 is Olazabal, owned by Douglas Miller and William Wargel, conditioned by Eric Foster, the pilot, Walter Rodriguez. A field of 11 in the holiday chair. It's our Saturday night featured event, and post time is in 7 minutes. It starts our late pick 3. And there they go in the 24th running of the holiday cheer. Heaven Street with a brisk beginning along the inside. Olazabal is gunning and started from the bottom, 3 quickly away. My Buddy B's in the fourth spot with his stablemate, Fortin Hill. The Bob is from the inside. Nighttime from the extreme outside. He's 7 or 8 lengths off the lead. Condemn races with True Temper. Let My People Go joins them. And at the back there is Manny Wah. So it's Ola Zabel and Heaven Street. 21-1. They zip along. Started from the bottom, is in the third spot. Here comes Nighttime. Nighttime's into the fourth spot. Got a very good opening quarter to chase after. He gets within 4 legs. And also closing in is to the far outside, Let My People Go. After that, My Buddy B. DeBob's waiting for somewhere to go in the two path. Condemn's trying to hit his best stride. Here comes Let My People Go in Nighttime. Nighttime has the lead at the 3/16. Let My People Go from his outside. Nighttime and Let My People Go. Nighttime's the leader at the 16th. Let My People Go's testing him every step to the wire. Nighttime and Let My People Go. Nighttime in prime time in the holiday cheer. Nighttime from Let My People Go. Fortin Hill checked in third. Nighttime in the holiday cheer. What a great Saturday night featured event, the 24th running of the holiday cheer. They rock and rolled up front, 21-1. You could see Nighttime was really hitting his best stride at about the 5/16. Let My People Go was closely there after him. And they had a pretty good little battle to the wire. 110 and 17/100, the final time in the holiday cheer. Photo's going to determine the winner. In the winner's circle is number 10, Nighttime. Nice claim back in Saratoga on the 11th of August for $80,000. Here's a stakes winner named Nighttime. 6-year-old chestnut horse by Majestic Perfection out of the Kittens Joy Mare Silent Joy. Owned by SB Stables LLC, Genstar Thoroughbreds, David Burnson, and Omar Aldaba. It's back-to-back for Billy Morey, back-to-back for Fernando de la Cruz, 3 overall for Mr. De la Cruz. Nighttime was bred in Kentucky by Brereton C. Jones. Ladies and gentlemen, directing your attention to the winner's circle with the trophy presentation for the holiday cheer is Mr. Chip Bach, our general manager here at Turfway Park Racing and Gaming. Congratulations to the connections of Nighttime. Here are some prices. The 10-cent Super, $248.98. Dollar Super, $2,489.85. 8-8, 10, Pick 3, $63 and some change. 10-8 Exacta, $73.12. 10-8, 9, Trifecta, $114.48. 8-10, Billy Morey, Fernando de la Cruz, double, $36.54. All right, fans. Brad Cox ends up being our leading trader here for the holiday meet. Tessa Walden is accepting the presentation there on behalf of Brad. So congratulations to Team Brad Cox. Dixiana Farms ends up as our top owner for the holiday meet, and trainer John Ennis is accepting the plaque on behalf of Dixiana Farms. So Dixiana Farms ends up being our top owner, and Brad Cox our top trainer. Jockey's standing. Jockey's race still up for grabs. We've got about, 3 more races to go. Luan Machado with a 2-length lead over Axel Concepcion. 2 more races to go. All right, 8th race begins our late daily double scratch 6. Oh boy. 4 Ghost Bike, 1 pound over the weight. 8th race begins the late daily double, and post time is in 21 minutes. And there they go. Deus Ex Machina, extremely eager to leave that starting gate. He's hustled out from post position 2. Golden Rain is also showing plenty of foot. Out of Alcatraz comes away running in the third spot, and Ghost Bike's in the clear from the far outside. Along the inside races Electrostatic, Lieutenant Jax from his outside. Midnight Channel is midfield, and he's a little more than 5 lengths off the lead. About 3 lengths to Sailor's Chance, a length in front of Broken Justice. It's about 5 to Commander Compton, and Breakout Stars at the back. 24 seconds, the opening quarter. Deus Ex Machina has the lead from out of Alcatraz, and Ghost Bike's on top of the action from the far outside. Golden Rain tucked in sweetly along the rail. Electrostatic is only 2.5 from the front. Lieutenant Jack has a little more than 4 lengths to make up. Now go to Midnight Channel. After them from the inside races Broken Justice, and going with him is Sailor's Chance. So with the lead still, Deus Ex Machina from the outside out of Alcatraz at a big number. Electrostatic looks like one of the players inside of Ghost Bike, who's being shrugged on. Here's one with a sweeping move. His name is Breakout Star. And Broken Justice is just begging for somewhere to go. And look at this split he's going to find in the two path. Here comes Broken Justice. Broken Justice up the inside. Breakout Star to the outside. Electrostatic fighting on strongly. And her Sailor's Chance. It is on the lead, Electrostatic. Electrostatic has the lead. Sailor's Chance, the late threat to the outside. Electrostatic. Tyler Cotter with a double. Electrostatic wins the eighth from Sailor's Chance, Breakout Star, and Broken Justice fourth. Number five, Electrostatic, 139 and 33, 100. Pretty cool race, lots of chances. Electrostatic sure did have a ton of horse near the quarter pole, between the 5/16 and the quarter pole, and he was able to keep that rhythm going all the way to the wire. While Broken Justice had a big look, so too did the 11 Breakout Star, 7 Sailor's Chance with a big late run, but it's the 5 Electrostatic winning the money. 7 Sailor's Chance with second, third place 11 Breakout Star, and fourth place number 12 Broken Justice. Sure to hold all tickets. Results are still unofficial. Unofficially 5, 7, 11, 12. Entering the winner's circle is number 5, Electrostatic. 4-year-old Abay Yelding by Midnight Storm out of the Cherokee Run Mare. Extra Sharp by Mark Greer. Winning trainer is Arnaud Delacour. Winning a jockey, Tyler Connor. 2 for Tyler. Was bred in Kentucky by Susan Kastner. Before we get to the nightcap, we are going to honor our top jockey for the holiday meet. A big congratulations to Luan Machado. Chip Bach has the winning plaque for Luan Machado, our top jockey. And race 8 is official. 5, 7, 11, 12, that exact at $100.82. $0.10 Super, $250, $0.15. Dollar Super, $2,500, $1.56. A10 5 Pick 3, $143, $0.14. 5 7 11 Trifecta, $434, $0.89. 10 5 Double, $39, and a couple of pennies. All right, now we can get to the Nikea. Abel Cedillo, new jockey number 2, Sanctify. Abel Cedillo picking up the mount 2, Sanctify. Scratch both of the also eligibles. Super High 5 carryover, $13,890.52. A mandatory payout with closing night. 22 minutes away at 10:05. And there they go. Slow start, Sanctify. Flowery Path and Stirred Up are showing plenty of speed. So too is Heavenly Dream from the inside. Gold Delmar is amongst the action. And from the inside is Bright Lady Day. She has the red silks. Evocation has the white silks with the blinkers from the far outside. And she's 6 lengths off the lead. Catalina Nina advances along the rail with the orange. And flanking her is Lendi. And it's a break of at least 3 lengths to Gallery Gal, then Banshee Moon. Vino Frizzante is second last and Sanctifies at the back. And Heavenly Dream speeds along at 10-1. Stirred Up makes her move. Here comes Stirred Up and Gold Delmar. Stirred Up's being pushed on. Gold Delmar looks like she has a little bit more horse at the quarter pole. We shall see. It is Heavenly Dream still with the lead. Stirred Up has the lead. Now from the outside, Gold Delmar's asked for her run. So Stirred Up now looks like she's going better than the outside gal. That's Gold Delmar. Still got a reel in Heavenly Dream. Heavenly Dream still has the lead. Stirred Up continues to chase the leader. Trying to close in and post a big, big upset is Gallery Gal. Gallery Gal has a little momentum. She's into second. She has Heavenly Dream in her sights. Here comes Gallery Gal to the outside. She's huge at 40-1. Gallery Gal, Heavenly Dream. Those two run 1-2, 40-1 upset in the nightcap. Dream on the line, third place to the 4, Stirred Up. Fourth place to the 9, Vino Frizzante, and fifth place to the 6, Gold Delmar. Couldn't quite get it out in the race call, so I figured I owed it to you under the slow-mo. 1:12 and 5/100, the final running time from the nightcap. One of the debutantes, Gallery Gal in the nightcap, 40-1 on the board. Fernando de la Cruz with a huge evening. Gallery Gal, a 2-year-old of Bay Philly by Cantharos out of the Artie Schiller Mare Armoire. By James McInvale. Morning trader Marcus O'Donnell. 4 for Fernando de la Cruz. And the nightcap is official. Late pick 3, $1,266.16. Nearly $26,000 for the late pick 5. The 5-1 exacta from the nightcap, $815.38. Trifecta, $812.10. The dollar double 5-5, $241.15. Late pick 4, $8,307.84. 10 cents super, $2,100, $1.35. Dollar super, $21,013.53. Better than 45K for our pick 6. Our late pick 5, just under $26,000, $25,979.38. 4 out of 5, $103.82. The super high 5, 5 with 1 with 4 with all, $12,561.48. 5 with 1 with 4 with all, better than 12 G's. $21,000 for that super, the pick 6. $45,079 and some change. That's a wrap for the holiday meet. Come on out tomorrow. We're giving one fan $124,000 in cash. Got to be part of our Players Club. We've got some music tonight. Got live music at Bourbon and Brews, the menus. So stick around this evening. Still giving away $700 every 7 minutes up until 11 p.m. We'll see you Wednesday, 5:55. Have a safe and happy new year. This has been Racing from Turfway Park Racing and Gaming. Good night, everyone.
Merry Christmas and a Turfway New Year.